Hey everybody, this is your girl Debra Coco from Just Give Me the Mic, and thank you for tuning into our show. We have a great show lined up for you each and every week, and we hope that you tune in. You can catch us every Sunday night at 10 p.m. on channel 68 on BronxNet, and MNN2 in Manhattan at 8 p.m. on Sunday nights. And make sure you subscribe to us on YouTube. I hope you enjoy the show. Now sit back, relax, and again, my name is Debra Coco, and welcome to Just Give Me the Mic. Hey, everybody. I hope everyone is doing well. It is Aries season, and your girl is an Aries, and I definitely turned up for my birthday. I really didn't turn up the way I wanted to turn up because I was supposed to be in Miami, but with all the rain that took place during the day that I was supposed to fly, I had to change my plans, y'all. Y'all know a girl was sad about that, but I definitely came up with some good alternatives, and I had a ball for my birthday. Shout out to all the Aries celebrating during this month of April. I hope you all have a good time, many blessings, and I hope y'all been following Just Give Me the Mic. We've been bringing some great quality shows to you, and I hope you have enjoyed. If you have not subscribed to Just Give Me the Mic on YouTube as of yet, make sure you go and search your girl Debra Coco or Just Give Me the Mic on YouTube, and make sure you subscribe to the show on YouTube. You can also follow the show Just Give Me the Mic on Instagram, Just Give Me the Mic on Facebook. Matter of fact, all social media. Okay, you can check out Just Give Me the Mic. So no excuses. Make sure you follow, and on YouTube, make sure you hit that bell, y'all, so y'all can be notified for new shows that are coming up. And you can also catch us Sundays at 10 p.m. on channel 68 if you're in the Bronx, and MNN2 in Manhattan. So if you know, if you've been following me, you know I've been doing the show for almost 10 years. Well, a little over 10 years, I should say, and I still enjoy bringing you quality interviews, news, stories, and great, phenomenal people that you can hear about, and hopefully you can learn something from my guests, all right? So today, I have another great show. I have a great friend of mine. He's a legendary MC. He comes from Harlem. His name is MC Silver Fox. He is joining me today. He's in the building. We have some great music to feature from him. A matter of fact, before I bring him on, we're going to go to one of his videos, Why. So check out this video, and we will be right back with the legendary Silver Fox.
Back of my head, I can't understand how the game's on change. still is poor. Problems of the world. Hip hop, I reminisce over you. I keep rock to see how smooth you used to do. Stretch in the street, feel my heartbeat. You're not the way you used to be. But you can't see the forest for the trees and the words are just seen. Come on, follow me. This grown man can't perform to the norm. I leave a legacy, but I'm gone from my firstborn. And I'ma face the storm, patient and calm. Mic in my palm and a song. I know I did wrong in my life, but I just might turn it wrong. It's the right step from the darkness to the light. I know it's a fight, but I'm ready like I am what? With both hands up, so come on and stand up.
Yes, 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 yes. Welcome to the show, the legendary MC Silver Fox, y'all.
Y'all.
Thank you, Silver Fox, for joining me today on the show.
Thank you for having me. Thank you for having me. No, man. It's been a minute. It's been a minute. I haven't been interviewed, but just give me the mic since I came down from California. You heard?
I know. And matter of fact, but hey, you was living in California at the time that I interviewed you. And I'm like, was that about 5-6 years ago?
About 6 to 7. Matter of fact, it might have been 7 years ago. Yeah.
So we've been friends that long, Silver Fox.
We have. Right? That's right.
We got united through hip hop, y'all. You know.
And then found out that our birthdays was a day apart from each other. That was crazy.
But I should have known, though, because your energy, you know, we Aries, we have Aries. That special energy, you know.
Aries,
what I mean?
Rule the world. We the fire sign, you know what I mean?
We are the babies of the zodiac. So it was very interesting when I met you, and we're going to go through, we're going to give some history because, like I said, it's been a long time.
It's been a minute.
So I want people to understand your history in the game. And like, you are still out here doing music. You're still in the studio. You're still writing rhymes. You're still spitting rhymes. You're still doing your thing. So give people some history on how you actually got started out in the game.
Well, hip hop is in my blood. And I was living in Alaska, like in the early 80s. And then I came back. It was in the 80s. Well, let's put it this way. I was living in Alaska. I came back to New York, and by then hip hop had started and so forth. And I'm from Grand Houses on 125th, you know, Amsterdam, Harlem, stand up. And the thing is that like I listened to people like Phyllis Ford, Treacherous Three, Dougie Fresh, you know what I mean? On the east side, it was the Crash Crew. You know what I mean? It was Pennelio, Disco P, my boys from St. Nicholas. You know what I mean? And it's like I gravitated to hip hop when I saw Eddie Chiba and the Chiba Crew and DJ Hollywood up in Columbia University. I was like, oh my God, this is what I want to do, you know? Right. And since I'm prolific in English language, I wanted to change the whole, you know, different dynamics, because I couldn't see me just doing like regular cadence. You know, I had to mix poetry, mix some haiku, mix some of this, mix some of that, and then put it together and go like, LeBron James, like that action. And so Tito from Phyllis Four, we used to hang out a lot, and we went to places like Joe Grant's, which we made legendary too. And, other places that we went to, and Tito would take me around and put me under his wing too. I was under, you know, he's a youngster. He was young, you know, right. Like 16. But
he was young. Okay.
Yeah, but that was hip hop, you know. And younger cats, they actually gravitate toward me because, you know, I got a lot of energy. I got a lot of, there's a lot of hype to me, you know what I mean? And I just stay active. So it's like, so we went down to Joe Grant's, you know, and at Joe Grant's, I met Coogi Rap, you know what I mean? And then he was just a young Coogi Rap, like about 12, 13, you feel me?
Oh, he was young. That's baby Coogi Rap right there.
Yeah, like. Cool baby rap. It was like, So I met Coogi Rap, and, we did some things together. I did a show out there in Queens with him. And he says I'm one of his major influences, which is really dope. And so then I got with Tito, introduced me to Charlie Rock and Larry D, and we came together and formed Fantasy 3. Wow. So, you know, mind you, I didn't even know them at that time because I was going around like you know, to all the parties and stuff. And these are my mi Puerto Ricano hermanos, you know, me and my Puerto Rican brothers.
Yes.
And so you know, they added some of that flavor that you know, and taught me some Spanish and stuff. So we formed Fantasy 3, and we were trying to shop our record. We made a demo, and we were shopping it around. And then we got with Julio Gina from La Familia Social Club up on 134th Street, y'all, 134th Amsterdam.
Harlem all the way. Harlem all the way.
And Julio put up some capital, you know what I mean? And we started making our demo, turned our demo into a record. So Master OC from Phyllis Four, he actually came in there to do the mixing. We had the great Pumpkin from Pumpkin and the All-Stars.
Wow.
Enjoy Records Pumpkin. He came in there, and I had the music in my head, but you know, he played it because they didn't know whether I could play it or not, even though I had a scholarship to Manhattan School of Music and so forth, and music was my life. Nice. But you know, it's all good. So we had Pumpkin, he played the music, and we had his Your Rock. And then, you know, it was being played everywhere. Boom, 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 it's Your Rock. The next thing I know, the Similarity came out with the Crash Crew, and they did Crash Crew on the radio, which I was highly vexed about. And
we're going to get into that, right? Right.
Wait,
let's hold up right there for 1 minute. So what made you mad when that came out? Because it was on... It was working with Sylvia Robinson at the time, right?
Right.
And so what was it, something about the beat? Like, what was it that...
It was, the record was an interpolation of our record.
Okay.
So it's like they sat down, heard the record, they played it for the band, and the band played it and said, okay, this is the record. You know what I mean? Yeah, so now it's like, of course I'm mad because this is my first record. You know,
right, your very first record, right?
Right, and I'm like, yo, wait a minute, this is our first record as a first group coming out,
right?
And we get bit by the Crash Crew, and I'm like, how that happen, man? They from my same area. They from, you know, they the East Side, we the West Side, but we still in Harlem. And I'm like, how that happen for a Harlem cat to bite on a Harlem cat? I mean, even Spoonie told me I couldn't say my name was Reggie Reg because there was another Reggie Reg. So I would have bid his name. I mean, that's my name. You know what I'm saying?
Right, that's
so,
your actual name too, right?
Yeah. And I'm like, wait a minute. So I was nice and courteous. And I said, okay, I won't do that.
Even though you was mad, yeah.
Yeah, I'm saying I'm going to be Silver Fox then. I won't be. But this is before they bid our joint, you know, like we was doing block parties, you know.
Okay.
All through Harlem. And I did one of them. I'm the R to the E-double-G-I-E. Took the BMT to the I-N-D. And the place to be. And the place to be. And then right, Spoonie was like, yo, man, yo, you can't do that, man. There's Reggie Reg already exists, man. There's a guy, Reggie. I'm like, oh, all right, Spoonie. Yeah. I mean, you know, I respect hip hop, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
So now I'm Silver Fox, and, you know, let my name ring some bells, et cetera. But then these cats, they bit my first record. You feel me? Now, come
and that
on.
Became a big record for them. So imagine.
Yeah, it became a bit.
That would have got it out first. You know what I mean?
We did get it out first, but we were an independent label, which was Specific Records, the guy named Clark J. Nobody heard of Specific Records.
Right.
So it's one of them, they thinking it's one of them obscure tracks or something. Oh, snap, what's this one? You know? But yet, our joint, it was being played everywhere. It was played on WHBI. The Awesome 2 was playing it. Red Alert was playing it. Mr. Magic, he was playing it. Everybody was playing it. Then Sylvia Robinson come along and said, yo, you know what? Here we go. Here, take this money. Don't play their record. Play this one.
Wow.
Now, so it was a lot of politic. It was a lot of... industry taking control, which industry could do that now. They could stop an artist real quick because they got money. And they have, you know, this is the 80s we're talking about. So this is before any, you know, any streaming, any, you know, the internet, all of that. You know what I mean? We couldn't put our music out there like that. So now here I am, Matt. I'm calling them the Trash Crew, and I'm going over to the projects with my 40 ounce of beer, sitting down going... playing our record on the box on the radio.
On they block,
yeah. Right. I could have got hurt because you know they projects is no joke. You know what I'm saying?
It's not. Right.
But I was kind of crazy, so I don't care. You know, I didn't care. And you know the way it went. So then we had a battle. Uh-huh. I wanted to battle. So we had a battle at Broadway International, and you know, all they wanted to do was do their record, and we do ours, and that's that. But it's like nah, because we made another record called Biters in the City, which is referring to them.
Right. So was that a diss track?
Yeah, it was a diss track. It's straight up. First of all, let's get this straight. The way we narrate, the others imitate, and this Ooh. We state, and sees we hate, who Ooh. Take what we create and try to simulate. Don't start the break. I know you can't wait to spit out your mouth. My words you ate, and your helpmates, let's locate. So from state to state, we can eliminate, and we castrate, cremate, amputate. We mutilate when we communicate. You can't negotiate because it's too late. Fantasy 3 is here to assassinate. We captivate the party people in the place. You biting them fees, we slap their face because we intimidate, terminate, dominate. And it's the hands of fate that made us great. They're just the biters in the city. It's like,
that's
just how it started. Oh, and it was like,
you know Reggie going to be mad at me for this story, right?
Nah,
this is long time over. I'm just joking around.
Of all of them,
hip hop history, y'all.
It is history,
right?
And Reg, you know, Reg admitted some stuff. He admitted that he bit it. I mean, I got it on tape.
But let's be real, though. A lot of labels was doing that, and we all know if you really know about hip hop, Sugar Hill was good for that. You know what I mean?
Sugar Hill was good for that.
And he was a young artist at the time. The whole Crash Crew was young.
Well, they were
just coming out. Right. So they're doing what their label tells them to do.
Right, you know? Right.
Right.
They do
right.
what the label says. They presented the music to them and asked them to write to it. So, which is what they did. But see, the thing is, they didn't care whose record it was. They didn't care that it was Fantasy 3 from the West Side. You know what I mean? So they like, yo, we could do something with this Crash Crew rocking on the radio. Yeah, yeah. They like, yo, let's simulate. Let's take what they did and remix, revamp it. Because, you know, like, and honestly, our vocals on the vocal side, it wasn't like, you know, tight hip-hop vocals. It was like, I'm like, in the place to be. I got a master's degree in rock and parties. If you want to feel free, here's my therapy. Just come with me and shake your body. I got you're out. Next thing, Charlie says his. Charlie Rock next in line, taking his time to make you feel fine. If you ever heard it better, the sun don't shine and the grapes on the
wind. Okay.
Wine. I got you're out. And Larry D, the sweetest of them all. You find me on the court playing basketball. Have a big fun. Enjoying the song because I'm cooler and cooler. I'm like, yo. So, you know, I knew all their rhymes because.
No, you saying the rhymes like you said them yesterday. Oh, you wrote them.
That's
awesome. Okay. But look, you saying these rhymes like you wrote it yesterday. Like, I always wondered. I said, how do artists, like, years later go on tour and they got, like, 15 songs they have to perform? I'm like, dang, you got to remember all them lyrics. But I guess after you perform them so many times, you never forget. You know what I mean?
And it's not just the performance of it so many times. It's the practice of it. Because I sit with my headphones and I listen to my stuff over and over again and analyze it and make sure that it's in the proper cadence or if I'm off a beat or if I, you know, so now I'm memorizing it and I got it. It's like I'm not reading from a paper, you know, first, like before I go in the studio, I'm practicing, practice, and then I'm ready to do it. So, and then the thing about memorizing the songs, I really don't know how it's done to per se, but I got rhymes from the 80s and from the 70s that I still remember. Like, even when I battled them guys, I was like, yo, when they come to rapping, let's be specific. You gotta be prolific and be terrific. Gotta be a writer, not a one night a biter with a tape and type writer. Also be politer than any MC, but if angered slightly, this will incite me not too politely to explode. What I release is a masterpiece that will never cease. So with expertise on pitch, have you ever heard a rock like this? Bet you never. But if you ever, it's bit, cause it's what I've writ. I'm never kind of fit now. Let's endeavor in this. What I do is of no consequence to you, which is of course a okay all the way live. And what you feel is necessary can prove to you I'm very extraordinary. I'm extraordinary, never very stationary. MCs get your dictionary, ladies know that it's a fairy tale, because I rock you well with all the girls of the world. I'm a clientele, and long as I live, the rock I give will turn the negative into the positive, so the inquisitive, right. No alternative, turn a fake MC into a fugitive from the way me fussle Latino in Italiano. Every time I rock, yo, it's bravissimo. And I go to the show incognito. All the girls know when they're libido. When I recite the rhymes and I write your butt, man, that just goes on and on.
And look, and look, I have to stop you because that's one of the things. No, because that's one of the things that really stood out about you to me is that you can rhyme like nothing, like effortlessly. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's like the words, everything just comes to you. I've seen you over the years. I've seen different music. I've seen you actually joined me 16 bars with Video Music Box. You've come through. They could drop any beat. It don't matter what the beat is. You had something for it. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? I've never seen you like, wait, give me a minute. Like, let me, no. It's like, yeah, what? Okay, that, you want that? I got you.
Oh, they be nah. But see, I got more rhymes than time. I mean, I could just keep going and going.
No, you could.
And yeah, but I mean, you know, that's freestyle. And that's what they're doing now. Like, people come up with bars on other shows, which will remain unmentioned. But they come up with bars, you know what I mean? And it's like, yeah, I was doing that way back.
Way back.
And keep going and don't stop until they was trying to take the mic from me. They was like, yo, fuck.
Okay, like, it's over. Somebody else got to go on now. Yeah, somebody. You still have more.
you already know. I know.
Because you was like, energy cannot be matched, actually. That's what I'm saying. I don't think so. Your energy is definitely up there.
Thank you. I'm blessed, though. I'm blessed, really blessed to be healthy, you know, to be able to breathe and be able to do what I love and have people love what I do.
Peace. So how do you think about what happened? Let's go back to that record, that first track for Fantasy 3 being taken by Crash Crew. Do you feel that kind of like changed the course for Fantasy 3? Did it help Fantasy 3? Did it hurt Fantasy 3? What kind of effect do you think that particular situation had on your group as a whole?
Well, it really hurt us big time because we bum rushed the record label, which was Specific Records. Mm-hmm. And then we actually formulated our own record label for the next track. So we had CCL Records. So as you see, everything else was on CCL Records.
Right.
But it really messed me up big time because I wrote all of this. I cultivated the guys. I showed them how to do things, how to breathe, where to go, how to, you know what I mean? I turned them into MCs. And then there was another, it was a step-by-step thing. First we had to create Fantasy 3 and be Fantasy 3. And then we had to market Fantasy 3 that promoted. And then to come with another track, because that record was really a hit, you know.
It was a hit. People still rock to that. Like, come on.
Yeah, I mean, you know? I know I get the royalties. I'm like,
oh, that's dope.
De La Soul. They did it on Stakes Is High. Wu-Tang Clan. There's a song called That Wu Shit.
Okay. You know?
And they did the thing. Scram Jones, he used the whole loop. There's a few others I can't, like, you know, I don't keep them. All I remember is rhymes. I don't remember the people.
right.
But that did
turn out to be kind of profitable on the back end because the industry did acknowledge that beat originally came from your group.
It's profitable as an artist.
Okay.
But CCL Records, when it went into Specific Records, it wasn't profitable as far as as far as like if they want to use it for a movie, it's going to go to the publisher. You know what I mean? It's not going to the artist. I'll get my 33 1/3% because I'm an artist, and so is Charlie Rock, and so is Larry D.
Okay.
However, CCL Records, it stands for Chico Charlie Larry. You know what I mean?
Chico Charlie Larry. Okay.
Right. Okay. So Chico, that's Julio Gina. That was the guy from La Familia Social Club that actually put up the capital so that we could do it.
Right.
Charlie.
Right.
Is his boy that brought it to him. So that's, you know, he was my boy too, you know. Charlie right. Rock became the vice president of CCL Records.
Okay.
And Larry D became the treasurer of CCL Records. And Silver Fox.
Became the what?
Became Silver.
the innovator of the whole Fantasy 3 situation.
Well, I was supposed to be an A&R for them. However, when I found somebody that I wanted to sign, I found out that I wasn't an A&R.
Oh.
And now, do we go in this into the story of the person I found that I wanted to sign? Is there a commercial in here?
Who is that person? Who is that?
It is a person that is now known.
Wait.
Now known as LL Cool J.
You kidding me? Come on now. You kidding me?
LL Cool J came to 134th Street to CCL Records because we had our address on the record label.
Okay.
So he came down there because he wanted to get signed. And then, of course, he wanted to battle. He battle anybody. I don't care. So I'm like, yeah, well, anybody. We could do it. Battle me, mom.
Right.
That, you know, he wasn't LL Cool J then. He was just some dude off the street.
Right.
So I'm right. like, battle me then. So we was going back and forth and back and forth and back and forth. And I'm like, hey, man, you good. And he's like, yeah, man, you good. So he hung up. I brought him to Julio. I was like, yo, this guy is good, man. He spit freestyle for him. He did something for him. And they were like, okay, yeah. But they wasn't impressed as
Why?
I was.
Why?
I'm like, heck if I know. But I'm like, yo, this guy is good, man. You should sign him. And he's 16 years old. He was 16.
He was in his prime. He's just coming out, right.
It was his time. See, right. There's a time. We older. The older, no, we can't. Our demographics is different. But with him being a 16-year-old, he can actually relate to 16-year-olds and the 17-year-olds.
The people who buy the records at that time, right. Those are the ones that's spending the money.
That's right.
And supporting the movement, you know.
Yeah. But the thing is that his imagery was he's a young guy.
Right.
So all the young girls are going to love him. And he's talking about his name, Ladies Love Cool James. I'm like, dude, man. You CJ to me. I'm going to call you CJ, all right?
CJ, you gave him the name.
I can't say, yo, LL Cool J, yo, bro. I mean, but when I introduce him to people, I'm like, yo, this is LL Cool J. Because that's, you know. Plus, he told me, don't be calling me CJ to people.
Right.
He may have been six. He may have been 16, but he's 6'2". So I said, okay, we looking eye to eye. And I'm 6'2" also. So you know.
Are tall. You really are.
Yeah, you know, I'm a point guard. You know.
Right.
I'll be on point. Yeah, like, yeah. So
the thing about it was that, you know, since everything was so fresh and new, like, you know, they kind of, I think that people were scared to take risks. They didn't really know where hip hop was going at that time. They didn't even really know how to market it, how to, like, you know, the demographics of who's really listening to it. And so they missed whoever that was. They missed a good one right there.
They missed it. Chico missed it. Charlie missed
Chico,
it.
Chico, Charlie. Who's Larry. The other one? Chico, Charlie,
Chico,
Larry.
Chico, Charlie, Larry.
Right. You know what they missed that mark. Right
they missed there. It. So what L do? He hung out with me for the summer. He hung out with me. We broke bread. We talked hip-hop. And I'm working in the record shop that we had, which was our distribution. Whatever. This is where we distributed our records.
Right, that's the spot.
So yeah, and we sold records and we had all of that. So that's that part, right? So we over there, you know what I mean? And he's chilling with me. So I'm playing I'm playing as yours, Tila Rock. And I'm like, yo, right, man, right. You come in to chill with me, man. You better bring some books, bring a pen, bring your, you know, and sit down and act like you in school, because this going to be school, man. We're going to do homework, and I want to listen to what you're saying and what you're writing. And put. So I took them everywhere with me. I took them to Joe Grant's. I took them up to White Plains, New Jersey. I took them to Spring Valley, New York. I took them everywhere, because, I mean, because he was always with me.
I mean, you helped his whole foundation, you know what I'm saying? Of him developing himself as an MC. That's dope.
And the thing, too, is that, you know, I'm not just blowing my horn because he mentions it, you know, and mm-hmm. it's documented and all of that on Rock the Bells Radio, too. And, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, you know, he's still my dope. I mean,
that's,
you know,
awesome.
We be in touch with each other. We still communicate and all of that. And I'm very proud of him. I'm like a daddy going, look at my baby.
Right in your eyes, right?
Yeah,
right.
Like, right. Look at my baby. He got his
but
name.
Isn't that a beautiful thing when you see somebody like just rise like that, like find their purpose and actually have the opportunity to live out their purpose? I think that is just amazing. That's a wonderful thing. Yeah. And to know that you've touched that artist, you've worked with that artist,
right,
and you had something to do with shaping that artist,
yes,
you know,
yes,
in the
indeed.
Very beginning, because, you know, people just didn't really know how to define hip hop at that time. But you know what? You actually gave me some jewels that I didn't realize. I didn't even know about Chico, Charles, and Larry. It was another there was another label you was on.
Yes.
What was the other one?
Oh, I'm on it was Specific Records.
Right.
And CCL Records. And I had my own label, Silver Fox Music US. And I was, and then also prior to all of that, 1999. No, that's ahead of that.
I thought
that.
It was Grand Groove or something. No,
Nah, Grand Groove. That's T-Ski.
T-Ski. Okay.
Yeah, T-Ski Valley's record label. But see, most of the time, I self promoted and self put out self music.
Okay.
Like after Fantasy 3, we made two more records, Summer and The Buck Stops Here. And I was really disgruntled with the whole label process with CCL Records, because it had nothing to do with me.
Right.
You know what I mean? I was just an artist on it. And the thing is, too, if they didn't sign LL, but yet they put, you know, Peso was on, my man Peso from Phyllis 4, and I got no animosity.
Peso was on that label.
He was
by
on
himself?
CCL. Yeah, he did on CCL Records. He did what? It's Time to Rock.
Okay.
And I think you might be able to find it on YouTube too.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, he was on CCL Records, and it was called It's Time to Rock. He put out a single. There was another group called the Magnificent Master and something. It was a little girl and three guys. One and to me, no, like there was one of them that really was trying to be an MC.
Okay.
I forgot his name.
One out of the four. Okay.
And the rest of them, and I'm going, yo, you're just gonna get together and put this stuff out. I'm like, but you're not even talking to me about nothing. Like, you know what I mean? You're not talking to me about it, because I mean, you got some whack stuff. Like, whoever heard of this stuff, right? Whoever heard of the record, whoever heard of, you know, and we hear of Peso, we know it's Time to Rock. But there's a way to distribute and a way to market and a way to promote. And even at that time, when you're having records and the one stops, you got to also get them to the radio stations.
Right,
you got to get,
right.
You know, and it's like, man, you got to take it to the club. I could go to the Fever with two records and just drop it off. I could go to Joe Grant's and just drop off records. I'm like, come on, there's a way. There's a street team. We can
get them
this.
In the DJ's hands. Get the records.
Yeah,
DJ's hands, you know,
man, but they wasn't listening to me. And the thing that was just detrimental for Fantasy 3 is that I had, with me having no parts of it, and I'm writing and
but
writing.
How did that happen, though? Like, how did everybody solidify a title for themselves?
Because I didn't have the money. I didn't have the capital at first, right? With the first record, I didn't have the capital, but I had the talent.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm like, I'll come with the talent, but y'all gotta put up the money.
Okay,
and,
I got
and
you.
But a boom. So then after that, got bit and all of that. Then, since they are boys with each other, you know, like Chico and Charlie, they on the same block. Like La Familia Social Club is on the same block where Charlie lived, and Larry is right there. Larry knew Chico, but you know, Charlie Rock, he knows Chico, like, you know, well.
Right.
And
right.
So it's a process of manipulation and a process of greed. You know what I mean? So it's like, I don't know. It all just came about.
I mean, it was hard times. I mean, and we all watched so many shows where artist groups got beat for money just all over the place during that time, you know? And we're talking about people that had like a little bit of money to having an opportunity sitting in different rooms, talking to people that can do different things. And people was trying to capitalize off of them situations. That loyalty that you have in the street may not be the same loyalty you have when you're sitting in a room behind a closed door when it comes to writing that check. And, you know, that still stands for today. So, you know, sad to say, but that's, you know.
But there was a lot of factors that, you know, because it was gangster. You know what I mean? Right. My man Chico, you know, rest in peace to Chico, too. But, you know, he was gangster, you know what I'm saying? He had his little social spot and he had other things he was doing.
Right.
And then, you know, and then they try to keep me dumbed down or numbed down in my brain. So it's like, you know, there's a lot of other things that come into play, you know, drugs, this and that.
Right.
With three people conniving, or even two, let's say two, with two people plotting against the one. And I don't know, you know what I'm saying? So it's like... Right. Right. It was crazy. I was like, yo, I'm done with y'all. And then that's when I was writing, Summer, and I wrote the Buck Stops Here. And what they did, because the Buck Stops Here is like they couldn't memorize it. You know what I mean? They couldn't memorize the words. And I'm like, look, we in the studio. This is going to be the record. So I could take the forefront. There could be in the background, it'll still be a Fantasy 3 song.
Right.
But what they did was when Summer was released, it was titled Summer and a / BW, The Buck Stop Here. Mm. So now it became one single.
Mm, okay.
And that really pissed me off.
Mm,
so right. I'm out. So now I'm out. I ain't messing with y'all no more. You feel me? I ain't fuck with you. Right. So
these are people that you help to write, develop. You know, you wrote for them. You helped to develop them.
Right.
And then they got in a position and they didn't do the right thing. And that happens a lot. To be told. You know what I mean?
Yeah, it's crazy. Right. And then it became like a whole process now with, you know, like even with my man Charlie Rock, you know what I mean? He wants to re-release It's Your Rock. I'm like, okay. You know what I mean? Because he got, since Julio died, more than likely, and I'm you know.
Right.
More than likely, he has the publisher.
Oh, so, right.
So he got the publisher. And then we tried to get back together like in the early 90s, and it didn't work out because my man wanted to eliminate Larry D and it just be me and Charlie Rock. And I'm like, you know, I was doing it and I was writing, but then I'm like, man,
you ain't feel right about it.
Yeah, I'm like, I don't like you, bro. I don't like you. So, you know, and it came to a point. So now all the tracks that we did that we did in the 90s. He's trying to re-release them. He's releasing tracks that we did in the 90s. If you look on YouTube, you can find Money in the Pocket.
Okay. With
Silver Fox and Charlie Rock. It's just me and Charlie Rock. It's called Money in the Pocket.
No Larry D, y'all.
No Larry D.
No Larry D. Larry D didn't make the cut on that.
He didn't make the cut. But we got a whole bunch of other stuff. Right, that got Larry on it because you know Larry was living down south and I was in Jersey and Charlie was in New York, so it's like it was easy for me to get here, but Larry had to come from the south. So we, you know, and I'm writing again. I'm writing everything again because I'm thinking, okay, we're going to be Fantasy 3 again, and I'm looking to now, like I was trying to look ahead to the future because we could live off of tracks that we did back in the day. We could all eat. We just, you know, people are doing it. We could all just go to clubs, do our tracks if we did it properly. Right. But nah, so I I didn't like that. And now
Greed kicks in and changes the whole dynamic. I mean, it's so much betrayal in this game. It's just so much everybody trying to eat off each other. It's just, every time I hear a story, when I talk to artists and they tell me about their journey and everything, I'm just like amazed, because half of the time, it's the people that was the closest to you, the people that you shared a room with, break bread with. And it's those are the ones that will try to capitalize off you. And it's a sad, sad thing. But I want to go into, because like I said, we talking about from the 80s to now, we in the 2000s. I found a video online from you that was released last year, right?
Yeah.
Straight spitting. So we talk about some time here, y'all. First of all, I don't even really have to say much, because they seen you throughout the show. You've been rhyming and freestyling and breaking it down since we got on here. So I like that. A lot of energy. And you know, we're going to go to this video. Then we're going to come back and talk about what's going on now, speed, and some other things that you're doing. I saw you got an award. Like, things are still happening. So let's go to Straight Spitting, and we'll be right back, y'all, with Silver Fox.
Okay. Straight Spitting, Silver Fox.
First of all, I'm the worst of all, the worst to call, cause I'm the first to brawl. Take them down, I ground and pound. I'm a hollow OG, Silver Fox on the rooftop in grand houses, 1350, Amsterdam like a gargoyle. We heavy metal here, boy, you gym for you. Wrap it up, back it up, I tried to ignore you, but now I wanna destroy you for acting up. You jokey, joking, poking a big dog with a stick. You gonna get bit, chewed up to a carcass. Why you acting like big dogs don't bite? Get your flashlight, my New York nights be the darkest. It's me and my shadow, he's living off the wall like Michael Jackson, yelling, curse you all for hating. I've been waiting impatiently, pacing the floor, ready for action. Punching the walls, putting holes in the sheetrocks. Ice Fox, for 20 years or more, they've been locking and blocking the door. That's right, I'm the prototype of everything you like. The type to bring a knife to a fist fight and slice, slice, slice. A big dog gotta bite, bite, bite. The worst without a curse in the verse. You better run, you better run. Yo, it's the calm before the storm, y'all. And it's fitting to pour on all y'all. I let the spittle drip. So many flavors like lightsabers and Skittles. Get straight spitting, leave you covered in phlegm like you spit in the wind. What you smoking, what you drinking, what you thinking, you better think again. I'm on that drink again and don't like you. When I see you, I'm gonna rip you from limb to limb, from the top of your head to the tip of your Timbs. It's like you in quicksand, sinking in, covered in mud till it hardens. So you better beg my pardon and bow down. I'm a New York giant, I'm shaking the ground, laughing at clowns. They brag them, we drag them to the Hudson, throw them in, watch them drown. Air bubbles, bubble boy, and that's that. I'm trouble boy, I'm a problem, that's facts. Who you playing with? Silver the Fox, stop that, stop kidding. I'm spitting since you was playing with building blocks. That's right, I'm the prototype of everything you like. The type to bring a knife to a fist fight and slice, slice, slice. A big dog that I bite, bite, bite. The words provide a curse in the verse. You better run, you better run. Straight spitting, I'm hitting like a sack of rocks, a sack of baseball bats. Take that, straight to the face, splat. Make that face flat. Call me curiosity, cause I be killing these cats and bringing them back 9 times. So I could drill him and kill him 9 more times with 9 more rhymes. The beast is the doctor, Frankenstein of rhymes. A monster maker, take a dabble pieces all mixed up and stitch it up, electrify it. Now it's alive with a Kango cocked to the side. Go ahead, it's your time, spread disaster. Get the whole world captured with rhymes. I'm bad, that ego saying, yes master, let's do it again. But this time, let's put him in black hoodie and Timbs. Make them a cool, diabolical, multi-syllable genius of rap, talking that street life, Silver Fox in the back. That's right, I'm the prototype of anything you like. The type to bring a knife to a fist fight and slice, slice, slice. A big dog gonna bite, bite, bite. The words provide a curse in the verse. You better run, you better run. That's right, I'm the prototype of anything you like. The type to bring a knife to a fist fight and slice, slice, slice. A big dog gonna bite, bite, bite. The words provide a curse in the verse. You better run, you better run.
is dope. Shout out to Speed, Joe. I know a Speed. Lot of artists work with Speed. I love yeah. that.
Speed is that dude. You know what I mean? We break bread together. He's a good dude. You know, and he's somebody I could trust. You know what I'm saying? It's like, you know, we share information, we share food, we share thoughts, and you know, we share secrets that, you know, and I'm good for keeping secrets. So it's like, you know, and we
y'all
share.
Y'all work well together. I know you go to his studio, like Johnny Wah, mm-hmm. Reggie Reg. He has a lot of legendary artists that come through.
Yeah,
do music with him. So again, like really, really shout out to him. He definitely seems to understand how to put the music together.
Yeah,
right. So yeah. y'all could really shine and do y'all thing on that. So
yeah,
But today, Dad, the show is almost over. We got another video to play.
No,
we got 10 minutes left to the show.
No,
tell us what's going on right now.
I
gotta thank you though because that was so interesting. I actually learned some stuff today, but I'm not gonna talk too much. What's okay. happening right now? I know you're still doing music because music is in you. Music is you.
What's happening
right now?
Hey, while during the COVID era, which is like, 2 years?
Yes.
So during the COVID era, all I did was write, record, you know, here and there. And I found ways of recording, by myself, where I could just record stuff and send it to a studio instead of me going there.
Right.
So right now, I got like 2 albums worth of stuff.
When is it coming out, Fox? When is it coming out?
I got my single. My single is out, Bees in the Trap, because I wanted to test out my distribution process.
Okay.
So I wanted to make sure that the music is distributed properly throughout the digital stores, because we're doing things differently now.
Right.
And then it's also about the videos, because I got to make my videos, because, you know, it used to be the music, but it promotes the video, but the video really promotes the music, and people buy it from your video or whatever. And with videos also, you could monetize it and get right. money from it. So, you know, I'm like,
let's do this. Let's go.
Isn't that nice
how the industry, like the whole promotional game opened up where you don't have to rely on a record label to really put stuff and package you and you know, put the little bells on you, send you out. You could do all that yourself.
I could do it all. Yeah.
And that money comes straight from the site to you now.
Straight to me.
No middleman.
And it shows me where it's being played. It shows me what countries are. So see, it also makes you global, you know, it puts you in a global thing. So actually I'm working on an international cipher with a bunch of cats from all over the globe. So I got some Japanese, I got some Chinese, I got some Australians, you know, I got people from all over, you know, and they are actually sending in, doing 8 bars, you know what I mean? And I wanted to reiterate upon Speed. He's working with Grandmaster Caz. They got the thing called 50 OGs, you know what I mean? And there's 50 OG MCs. Yeah, we got, and there's everybody on there. There's just
everybody. When is that coming out though? Because I heard about that on the low a little while ago. Like, you know, I'm waiting for that.
That's a Caz project. Okay. So we got to talk to our Aries.
Yeah.
We got to talk to our Aries brother.
Yes.
Because that's not how we move.
And April 18th, you know, he got the big party celebration going down at Andrew.
Right. I'm there.
Out and support. Yeah, I'm definitely coming out.
I'm there. It's like a Caz day, basically. Oh,
start early.
Yeah. And I want to utilize these last 5 minutes to say,
yes, go ahead. I'm not saying a word.
I got an album with DJ Speed. You know what I mean? So we're going to sit back. We're cultivating it. We're going to put it out. It's going to be coming out soon. My man, Daryl Fortune, we got that. That's with a single, Bees in the Trap. We did that. And we have a whole album coming from Daryl Fortune. And I've been working with him also. I'm working with a few producers. I want to say that the people that's going to be on there, my man, Sedan, and not Sedan X, but Sedan from Queens, the God of Sound. We got Chuchi Sanders. She's on a couple of tracks, a track called Pop Up and another one called Be the One. Thank you, Chuchi. I got my nephew Jag. He's on one. I got J-Ton the Mac, J-Mac is on there. I got Reggie Reg Crash Crew. He's in a joint called Harlem.
Nice.
Boom, boom, boom. I got Grand Surgeon. Got B Franks, Mikey D, you know what I'm saying? Mikey Destruction.
Let's say yes, that. Mikey Destruction. Shout out to Mikey. Yes. Yeah.
And Mikey Destruction is working with DJ Speed right now, yeah, too.
Oh, he is.
Yes, indeed.
Okay. See, these are, I didn't know that.
Let me throw the gems out. Let me
throw the gems out. Throw the gems.
I'm like, yeah.
Yes.
So all of this is coming. All my stuff is being distributed through two different distributors. And right now, the first track is on DistroKid, which has put me out on in a global situation. And, you know, we're doing our video. And I ain't trying to be just big up on me, but I'm big up on Fox. Because Fox is bad, man. That's a bad dude.
Hey, you're supposed to be big up on Fox.
Yep.
You're supposed to.
And so, you know, I've been chilling. I've been staying away from the shows because people be showing up. And next time they leave, they got COVID. You know, I seen people have COVID 1 week and the next week they in the kitchen cooking, talking about come see me.
Right. I see people catch COVID 3-4 times. Like, stay down.
Because they just can't stop. They can't stop. It's like, they I gotta go where the COVID's at. Where the COVID
at. Right. Yeah. But I'm glad everything is calming down. I'm happy that the city's opening up.
Yeah.
I'm happy to live life again, you know, and not feel like I'm boxed in. And, right. You know, and right. Be healthy. We made it. You know what I'm saying?
Hey, because, you know, I can't have walls. You know, the walls be closing in on me. I'm a hypomaniac.
No, you got that energy. You got that energy. Where can people follow you and find you? Where's your music going to be put up?
Look on every social net, every digital platform. I'm all over the place. I'm on Tidal, Rhapsody, Apple Music, iTunes, whatever you can name. You can say Alexa, play MC Silver Fox.
Right. You and that's how it should be. Right.
Yeah, Siri, play MC Silver Fox. and it's like, yo, believe me, I'm everywhere. I'm SoundCloud. I got free music on SoundCloud. My SoundCloud plays Silver Fox Music US at SoundCloud.com. I got my LinkedIn pages. I got Reverb Nation that has some other tracks. You know what I'm saying? I got two Reverb Nation, one for San Diego, one for Brooklyn. Just look under ReverbNation.com. Look for MC Silver Fox. I see what else. Oh, look, walk around through Harlem. See if you can find them. I mean, you know, yeah, I'm everywhere.
I enjoyed this interview so much. I'm telling you, I enjoyed it.
You already know.
Day one, we always laugh. We have fun. We have fun together, celebrated birthdays together. Like,
yes,
the energy's
yes.
always crazy. You know,
you got a special crazy. Place. You got a special place in my heart. Do it at me and mana. Para siempre. That means yes. forever. You know what I mean?
Forever.
That's real.
Ever.
That's real talk.
Forever.
Yes. And ever.
Yes. I love high energy. You know, we got this. We got one more video for y'all. Okay.
Yes.
So make sure you support MC Silver Fox. Go to all of those websites. Uh oh. Go ahead.
This video features Macy Gray. Just like to say that. Macy Gray.
Right. Been here before, and it features Macy Gray and Silver Fox, y'all. Make sure you support him on all his social media networks. Support, follow, subscribe to him on YouTube. What is it? MC Silver Fox 125 on YouTube.
Silver Fox 125.
Yes, support the YouTube channel and check out his music. I mean, he has rhymes for days, y'all, for days. He can definitely do one of the marathons for rapping. Got it.
I was going to do something called the 65 and put 65 tracks out there.
Oh, my God.
I changed my mind.
All right. Well, okay. Well, thank you so much. I will see you soon because we got to still, it's still April. We still got to turn up for Aries. Yeah. We ain't done yet.
I'm ready. Soon as this guys. Interview over, it's 4:20.
It's 4:20? Okay.
Yeah.
All right, y'all. Check out this latest video from Silver
Peace,
Fox,
everybody. Y'all. Thank you, Coco.
You're welcome.
Been here before. And I'll be back.
Maybe this time.
Maybe I have to stay here forever.
Forevermore.
Silver Fox forever. Silver Fox forever.
I've been here before, no stranger to danger. In the shadows, watching ballers fall, stick in the dirt, gangbangers, face on a shirt, mirrors on walls. I saw it all, I've been here before. Been through war, the sole survivor. Since the 60s, these streets trying to get me. Trapped off, now I'm 60 a boss. Still here while others die. Still putting my middle fingers up in the sky. Been here for decades, born and raised in the PJs. 125 on the west side of Manhattan. Harlem, we're well known for the rap and the rhyme and the snapping at the drop of a dime. I'm still here shining like a diamond, still here grinding. Go hard, believe this. Go hard since you was a fetus. I'm still here, yes, it's because I know God and Jesus. Been here before. I'll be back. Projects my eldest daughter saw when she opened the door, screaming. She was so little I hit the gun and the drugs, and just in case sent to the hospital. Plastic surgeon fixed my face, a good look. Now I still got a good look, but no smiling. Been here before, Rikers Island, C-74. When I was hardcore, I was there with braids in my hair. With Ronnie Vaughn and Mike Nice, R.I.P. Thanks to Julio Dina, R.I.P. for bailing me. Been here. Been here before. And I'll be back.
Maybe this time.
This time. Maybe I can stay. Forever.
Forever.
I've been here before, causing casualties. To any MC, battle me, stop that. Mentor to the best MCs like LL, Coogi Rap. My life's like a movie, black. Fright Night, the Vampire Lestat. Check your neck, these cats in the bricks is so sick with no respect. You can get your neck checked, that's why I still sit with the back to the wall. Cause I've been here before, so even when I'm on tour, New York to the Jersey Shore, San Diego to Utah, I stay ready for war. It's that simple, that's my mental state of mind. It kept me alive in a world with peace of mind. It's so hard to find. I find mine sometimes when I lock the doors. Let my sound bump the wall. Silver Fox, and I've been here before. And I'll be back. You heard?
Forevermore.
Silver Fox, forever.
Forevermore.